save what's left for everything is gone. Sweet love, my oldest friend.
Green Leaves Fall from the Strictly Arts Theatre Company is a story of how a young black boy orphaned by the riots struggles to integrate into a middle-class world after he's adopted by a white family. Just breaking it down to the core, we're looking at transracial adoption, aren't we? Why do you think it's still such a hot potato issue?
Well, I think at the moment, even now, people are still struggling to integrate, especially in terms of community cohesion or people feeling like they don't quite belong to a certain society, a specific social group. So I think that in regards to where we are now in time, present time, it's still happening, just on a very smaller scale. It might not be adoption, but somebody somewhere is feeling like they don't belong. And I think that's the main theme really on the show, yeah.
Unemployment in the United Kingdom has reached 3 million for the first time since 1930.
Those years ago, over 30 years ago, bullying was seen as, if you were a kid, it was an occupational hazard, really. It was something that you had to deal with. But was that why you chose to set it in Brixton, or certainly after Brixton, in the early 1980s?
Yeah, there were many reasons, actually, why we chose to set it there. And my main reason was there were so many similarities in 1980s Brixton as there is now, you know, the present day. I mean, the riots, for example, the recession, the unemployment. There are a serious amount of things that were happening now that was actually happening in 1980s.
Because Hackoy's character grows, becomes something more involved in the Brixton kind of riot scenario, and that happens quite often today, where people leave and join these
radical groups.
And radical groups.
It is something that's happening among young people now, and this was the closest time I could find that was a parallel universe to what's happening at the moment, and I thought that was really important for the play to not be set in present day, but have the exact same issues that people can identify with.
Now, my character's called John. And we join him in the play very early on with our central character, Kieran. And John has never seen a black person before.
What about you, huh? Will you be applying for any extra courses?
Does he even understand what I'm saying?
Or should I speak monkey for you? There's no need for that! You don't belong here!
He's very wealthy and he's very ignorant. He's been brought up in a very sheltered world. And he tries to mimic his father's reactions to everything. So quite clearly, John's father, my character's father, is a racist. So my character John mimics him as often as possible, but doesn't really understand what he's doing. In the end, he's just a young, ignorant child who doesn't really understand what he's doing wrong. And eventually, that ignorance grows in the character to what it is now.
Picky, is that you?
Probably doesn't even think he's being racist. Assumes that he just thinks he's being very funny.
He thinks he's hilarious. He thinks he's absolutely hilarious. So he feels like he's getting away with it because his friends are laughing. Because he's the only black kid at the school as well. He's got his support behind him, so there's no reason for him to stop.
And what about you, Piccaninny? Will your parents be getting involved?
His parents are my parents.
Oh, what's a Piccaninny?
My dad said you don't have to pay for your education because you weren't born in this country. Is that true? He said he's on the assisted places scheme.
No, he has to pay like everybody else.
What's the assisted places scheme?
Poor people get to go to fee-paying schools for free. Makes me sick.
The point that Josh just raised is very important. It's kind of mob mentality where you don't quite understand. But because everybody's with you, supporting you, then something that is terrible and awful then feels okay because you have the support of everybody that's alongside you. Because we're a physical theatre company, we have to be very specific, and we're putting some movement pieces, you know, physical, visceral pieces that should be able to connect the dots. And as it's a piece that will develop and continue to go into different theatres, in different places and in different spaces, eventually we will get it pinpointed in such a way that all audiences will be able to get something from it.
Something we absolutely believe in, and we're going to build and keep building until it really does reflect the society of today and yesterday.
What are these physical pieces?
It's an external expression of an internal thing. I think that's the only way I can express it, really. It's an external expression.
So it could just be a gesture or a facial movement or something.
Yeah, it
pulls out of reality and shows you the relationships and what's really going on, because so much of what we do is subtext, and this is where it comes out. Yeah, I think it's quite new that we've been mixing so much text and so much physical theatre together. That is fairly new. It happens, but they're so separate.
I think I want to go home now.
Certainly. That's a thousand tiny paper cuts of line. Sweet love, my oldest friend. Have we come to the bitter end? We come to the bitter end, the bitter end. Fall when we crash down. Through all of these years, I can accept it's over now. I won't let go. Sweet love, my oldest friend. Have we come to the bitter end?
We're getting so much support from all over the place. We can only be thankful for that.
Have we come to the bitter end?